Today we will see absorption of water through the roots. As we know well, water is the main constituent of plant cell. 90 to 95% of water is available with the protoplasm within the cell. Water is universal solvent. As water plays a vital role in all metabolic activities within the cell, water is able to dissolve organic substances like carbohydrates, amino acids, and organic acids. The best example of photosynthesis takes place in presence of water, in which 6 molecules of carbon dioxide, 12 molecules of H2O, which gives us C6H12 and O6, plus 6 molecules of H2O and 6 O2 will release. Opening and closing of stomata is governed by the water. So today, with the help of animations, we will see how water moves from root hairs to the xylem cells. Water potential is a concept with the help of which water moves from the soil to the root hairs, and from root hairs it moves to the endodermis, and from endodermis it will reach to the xylem cells, and from xylem it will reach to each and every part of the plant body. This video shows us water movement through a root. As far as structure of the root is concerned, this is root hair which is in contact with the soil water, then parenchymatous cells of the cortex of the root, and then endodermis. Beyond that, the presence of xylem cells. Adjacent to the xylem cells, presence of phloem cells. If we look the close-up of the root cells, there are certain Casparian strips which are present on the cell wall, which blocks or which work as a wax. So now we'll see the root hairs. As the water potential of the soil is zero, water moves from soil to the root hairs because the water potential of the root hair cell is negative. So this diagram shows us the movement of water through a special proteins called as aquaporins. Aquaporins are the proteins. Movement of water within these proteins called as aquaporins. Active transport as well as passive transport. So this is a model of aquaporin. In the center of the aquaporins, the water molecules moves. So this is a diagram clearly showing us the movement of water molecules from the center of aquaporins. So this is the structure of the root, endodermis, parenchyma cells of the cortex. How water moves from the parenchyma to the endodermis. What is the role of Casparian strips? How Casparian strips help for movement of water? So we have two pathways. The first one is apoplastic. Apo means away from the cytoplasm, and plast means structure or form. So this is the structure of plant cell wall, pectin, cross-linking glycans, cellulose microfibrils, middle lamella, primary cell wall, plasma membrane. So as this contains so many spaces, so water moves. So in this apoplastic pathway, the water moves through the cell wall from one cell to the another cell, and at last it will reach to the endodermis. So this pathway is called as apoplast pathway. Now we'll see the second pathway, symplastic pathway. Sim means within or together, and plast means form or structure. So the movement of water through the cytoplasm of one cell to the other cell. Now there is a space called as plasmodesmata. So the movement of water from one cell to the another cell through plasmodesmata. So this is a pore. Cytoplasm links between the cells called plasmodesmata. Now water is available through the endodermis. Now how water moves from endodermis to the xylem? So this is a very interesting movement of water from endodermis to the cytoplasm through cohesive force in apoplastic moment and negative water potential movement of water in symplastic pathway. So the water will move from endodermis to the xylem through osmotic pressure. The movement from higher concentration to the lower concentration. So the xylem tissue, movement of water from the cytoplasm from higher concentration to the lower concentration. As the sodium, the concentration of ions are more in the xylem, due to which the water will move from cytoplasm to the xylem through active transport of sodium and passive transport of the water. So the movement of water from soil to the root hairs and from root hairs to the endodermis and from endodermis to the xylem cells. So these are the key points of movement of water